A total of 16,043,953 Ghana cedis was captured in the 2015 annual report on the petroleum funds to have been the payment made for the construction of dams and irrigation infrastructure in the Upper East and West, Central and Voto regions. In the Agwatime, Ziope and the Ketu North district in the Voto region, the Keime and the Ohau irrigation projects were respectively captured as benefiting from the 16 million Ghana cedis. We visit the projects to ascertain the progress of work and to check whether value for money was considered. In 2014, the Ghana Irrigation Authority awarded the Keime Irrigation Project located at Azonko in the Agwatime Ziope District and the Ohau Irrigation Project located at Ohau in the Ketu South District to Gruma Twins Company Limited at a project cost of 11.4 million Ghana cedis.
Anyways, they are not able to harness water and they are not able to farm. And that source of water used to be, is what the water that they drink, they use it for washing, and it was a major problem. So since 2007-2008, the request started coming. We did our studies, we were supposed to even start work around that time, but it couldn't happen. Where to get funds from, and it was really of a challenge. So 2013, yeah, then this year again they started putting in requests because it's real fed agriculture that is being practiced within that area. It means that they will have to wait till it rains before they start their farming activities. In the south here, you know, the rainfall is very erratic. So most of the time you go to the community and people are sitting down and they're waiting for the rain. But with the onset of irrigation, it means that instead of sitting down waiting for the rain or harvesting and making some returns, maybe once a year. It's going to make it twice now.
Established in 1974, the Keime project was in its second phase of irrigation and drainage construction when the dam's embankment failed, leading to season of further development. A total of 459 meters of canal were at the time completed. But as of December 2014, these structures were dilapidated. Gruma Twins Company Limited by agreement is to make the 18 months stipulated project duration ready in June 2016, calculated from December 2014. Any delay on the part of the contractor or the financier in completing the project will extend the distresses and tribulations of communities and project's catchment area, who for decades have been resorting to unsafe drinking water sources and an unstable rainfall pattern for farming. The project is held in high esteem by community members for obvious reasons. According to Joseph Nate, a considerable number of people in and around Azonko will be given a reason not to migrate into cities when the project comes on stream.
We used to cultivate, it's a vegetable crops actually. But you see, the I think the focus of government is to ensure that there's job creation within the every setup, so that the youth that run from the villages and maybe their communities to Accra, looking for greener pastures, can stay within their community and work. So more or less, when this project is completed, what we expect is it will boost the agriculture network in that area. It's a farming community, and they are going to go into vegetable cultivation.
As at the time of our visit in January 2016, the Keyime project was 90% complete. The dam's embankment has been completed. What is left is the development of the land on which the crops will be cultivated and the finishing touches on the canals and the spillway channel. But these feats have been achieved by Grumar Constructions Limited, not without financial breaches on the part of the Finance Ministry. At a meeting with the Chief Executive Officer of Grumar Twins Company Limited, Sofo Alhassan Zakari, Mr. Zakari could not hold back to his frustrations as he pours them out to the ASAP team visiting.
Do you know when was the last time Grumar Twins was paid on this project? Look at the certificates that are with finance. Look at the total certificates that are with finance. All these monies are not paid. All this money, this is Keyime. This is where you are. Mm. It's not paid. Another Ohau Keyime, it's not paid. Another Ohau Keyime, it's not paid. This one, for the other project, it's not paid. This one, it's not paid. This one, it's not paid. All in total, 14,349,000. And we are standing here and talking about what? And talking about what? My brother driver. And talking about what? Over 140 billion. And talking about what? That one alone is enough for my bankers to put me into jail. Look at the kind of collateral that you use to support this, to get that money, and you people will take it and keep it there. And said, you'll be paid, you'll be paid, you'll be paid. And you are not paid until December, until January, until February. Even the first quarter is not yet out. So we don't even know whether, if it is out, how much is going to be the quantum? Whether it will, they will give us a lot to our ministry, which can supply. I'm not the only contractor, we are many.
In summary, money is expected to be released from the oil revenues to fund these life-saving projects are released sporadically.